Hi guys, it's Marc Zicree, Mr. Sci-Fi, and yes, that is a genuine letter on original Star Trek stationery from Mr. Gene Roddenberry, back when the show was on in 1966. So I was just a kid then, but this is the wall of my place with letters from Kurt Vonnegut and Studs Terkel and many of my heroes, and especially Gene Roddenberry. I got to go to the Star Trek set when I was a kid. I met Nichelle Nichols when the show was on. I got original scripts from Star Trek when the show was on, and later met Gene Roddenberry, and of course wrote for Next Gen and DS9 and all of that. But the reason I'm having this conversation with you today, Mr. Sci-Fi, is I want to attend Marc Zicree of Space Command. You all know who I am. Is I wanted to talk about how things were done back when I started in television and how they're done now, and why that's enormously better now, in my opinion, than it was even back then, even though there was some great television made. And as you know, we're in post on Space Command. This, by the way, is a Space Command gun, one that was used in the production. Yay, Space Command. It's based on a design by Ed M. Schwiller, and this is a prop that's used in the film itself. Very, very fun. I love all that stuff. So, okay, so here, let me get into this. And you guys can follow it at home. It's like a recipe. You can do this yourself. If you want to create your own science fiction franchise, here's how you do it. Basically, in the old days, the way it would work, let's say you wanted to write for Star Trek, or, well, let's say for Next Gen, or DS9, or Sliders, on which I was a producer, or many of the other shows I worked on, Babylon 5, etc. Here's how it would work. You'd have a writing staff, but generally that writing staff was very small. For instance, on Sliders, the entire writing staff was three people. It was me, Chris Black, and Bill Dial. That was it. And David Peckinpah, the showrunner, did one script, the first script of the season, but then he was busy making the show. So we had a 22-episode order, and of those 22, half of them we would write ourselves in-house. And we were, of course, charting the entire season, season four of Sliders, the season that I was on the show. But the other 11 episodes that season would be freelance. So every day we were taking pitches from freelance writers. Every day somebody had a chance to write for Sliders, and it was the same on Next Gen, DS9, all those shows. They were all taking pitches every single day, and that's how I sold to Deep Space Nine and to Star Trek The Next Generation. It was basically, I would come up with ideas, I would watch the show, I'd be aware of what they had in development, I would spend several weeks jotting down ideas. I would generally, when I was going into pitch for a show, I'd try and come up with about 100 ideas, and I would winnow those down to 5 or 6 that were completely worked out, very detailed, and then maybe a handful of what I called springboards. There were maybe a few paragraphs, and then and so forth. But I would have a lot of different stories that I'd be cooking up and seeing what was the juiciest. So for instance, Far Beyond the Stars on Deep Space Nine was one of those, and you try and find something that spoke from your own personal experience, but also really was the voice of the show as well. There was always that intersection, and always something that you'd never seen before, something that was unique and distinctive and truthful and all of that stuff. But so that's how it would work in the old days, but that is not how it works now. So those of you who are hoping to go in on a pitch and sell a show and write a script and so forth, and by the way, it's pitching pilots, that's more similar now. You'd go into the network, you'd pitch an idea, you'd lay out the entire series. But there are many, many more networks now, but again, the network notes are very intrusive, particularly if you've got a studio and a network aboard, and a lot of my friends who are running shows, they bemoan the fact that they don't have an authorial voice. They're not able to drive it in the way that, say, someone like Rod Serling could in the old days. But now, so there's no more freelance. It's all staff written. There's almost no freelance. And shows are 10 episodes or 8 episodes or 12 episodes of a season, so they don't have as many slots. And the staffs are much larger. Some shows, there's one show where it had like over 20 writers and they weren't even doing 20 episodes. So I was thinking, well, you can't even have one episode per writer. But here's the other side of it, the way of doing it now, which is the way I'm pursuing now, which I love, which is, in the old days, you had to have the studios or the networks, or both, greenlight your idea to get something that you could make, that you could put out to an audience. Now, those of you who have been following me here, and on my Facebook page, and on Kickstarter, and all of that, here's the way it works now. If you have an idea for a science fiction show, if you have a track record, great. If you're a science fiction novelist, if you've written for science fiction TV shows or movies, if you've got a fan base, great, but that's not vital. Essentially, what you do is you start going to science fiction conventions. You start meeting writers and you start meeting actors, because the science fiction actors go to the conventions. And if you have a wonderful idea and if you're willing to back it up and really finish what you start, And maybe you shoot 5 or 10 minutes so you can show them what you have in mind. Maybe you've got concept art. You know, I met Ian McKagan. He's a brilliant designer, and he became my friend and part of my team. So when he's not designing, you know, Rocket, you know, Raccoon for, you know, Guardians of the Galaxy or Darth Maul for Star Wars, he's designing for me, which is why the Space Command uniforms look so great. But I digress. So what you do is you come up with a great idea. You really, if you're going to be a writer, you better learn how to write a script. You know, learn your craft. If you're going to be a director, you know, learn your craft, but or bring aboard people who have those skills. There's a lot of writers who have written for your favorite shows who are probably sitting twiddling their thumbs nowadays. So if you reach out to them, if you meet them, everyone's on Facebook. You can find these people. You know, you can coordinate with them, collaborate with them. If you're the engine that drives it, they'll be happy to affiliate with you if you're really going to take it the whole nine yards. Because it's just too hard to do on your own. But okay, so then you go to conventions, you meet the actors, you see if they'd like to become part of your universe. You know, they want to work, they want to be part of something quality. Of course, and quality, by the way, helps a lot. If you're going to do something of great quality, people want to be aboard, because most people don't have that chance often to be of something of quality. More often than not, they're having to do shows that are disposable, movies that are disposable. If you stand for quality, if you stand for an emotional truth, if you stand for something fresh and exciting and entertaining, they're going to want to come aboard. So you reach out to them, you affiliate with these people, you gather them to you, you collect talented people, actors, writers, directors, producers, makeup people, concept designers, everyone. And you also get to know people who are influential, the decision makers, the taste makers, who have huge followings on Twitter, on YouTube, anywhere and everywhere. And you start to become friends with them, and you help them, you promote them, and they'll in turn do the same for you. If your work is deserving, and if you finish what you start, because most people do not finish what they start. So then you raise the money on Kickstarter. You set a modest budget, thousands of dollars, not millions. And then based on that, then you can, after that, you can sell investment shares. And again, 35 shares or 35 investors, you make it an amount that people can afford, a few thousand, not millions. Again, you're not looking for one guy to put in $1 million. You're looking for 35 people to each put in maybe like $7,500. And that, combined with the Kickstarter campaign, allows you to build your dream, to create your dream, to make your films. And again, I'm being very specific because out there, I know some of you have dreams, you've got scripts sitting in drawers, you've got short films that maybe have shown at a few festivals, but you don't have to do that. You can have the world stage. Just follow these steps, just like you were making an angel food cake. You look up a recipe, you find one that's good, you follow the recipe, voila, you've got an angel food cake. So this is how you can do it. Gene Roddenberry, if he were around now, he would be going the Kickstarter route, I'm sure of it. He'd be reaching out to his audience, because why deal with crazy networks, crazy studios? And look, I don't mean to badmouth these guys. They are great, they are wonderful, they are talented, they are successful. They are a great route, and so I apologize if I'm bad-mouthing people. I don't mean to, but what I'm saying is that you can greenlight yourself. So this is just me talking about how it used to be, where you could break into TV and have a career by pitching freelance to shows. That is no longer the case, but now you can pitch directly to your audience. And your audience, if you love it, and if you do it well, and if you deliver, because most people are half-assed and don't deliver, if you finish what you start, if you say what you mean and mean what you say, and off you go, and you come from the heart, like my dear friend Ray Bradbury did, and like I try and do, magic will happen. And I'm saying this, you know, in post-production of my first Space Command film, ramping up my second, people are investing in me and my dream. People around the world, they are dear to my heart. They are family now. So that's about it for now. But I just want to share this with you. And if you go and make your dream come true, I will applaud you and celebrate your journey, just as I know you all are celebrating mine. So that's it. Marc Zicree, Mr. Sci-Fi. If you want to comment, like, share, subscribe, please do so. And we will talk to you again really soon. Bye-bye.